What went through your mind when you were watching the squad?
Well, several things went through my mind.
Clearly.
First things first. My God. These boys. I mean, Duke. Whoa. Let me tell you something right now. Zion Williamson is special. Now, I had to check Mr. Jalen Rose just a few minutes ago when we were on Get Up.
Leave me out of this.
I'm leaving you out of this. This man had the audacity to unmitigate a goal to go on national television that said Zion Williamson would not have been a starting five member of the Fab Five. Excuse me. I love Jimmy King and Ray Jackson, but Zion Williamson wouldn't have started.
It has to be a super six.
Just stop it, all right? That's number one.
He thinks they can't shoot.
So I got to get that off my chest, all right? My God. It was something special to behold. This kid, he ain't even the best team on Duke. The best boy on Duke. R.J. Barrett is the truth. The truth. He is a faster, more athletic version of Jalen Rose when he was on the Fab Five. I mean, this brother is special, okay? Those are the thoughts that came to my mind. Here's another thought that came to my mind, Max Kellerman. This was supposed to be the top two recruiting classes. Well, I've never seen such a drop-off between class one and class two. I mean, I have been, in the interest of full disclosure, for those that may not know, I wrote for the Philadelphia Inquirer for 17 years. One of my very first assignments at the Philadelphia Inquirer in 1994 was the beat writer for Temple University covering John Chaney. Their number one nemesis was John Calipari, and UMass when they had Marcus Camby and Lou Rowe and Mike Williams in the crew, okay? My relationship with John Calipari goes back to 1994. Ladies and gentlemen, that's damn near 25 years.
Yeah.
I have never seen John Calipari team so dominated the way they were last night. They were completely outclassed. I'm not even putting it on coaching. I'm putting it on the recruiting because clearly.
Is this like the Alabama of college basketball?
It might be.
I want to get to that.
Let me say this to you. Listen, it's just one game. And I understand that. And I got to watch them tonight against Kansas. But I must confess to you, if I see this tonight against Kansas, Max Kellerman, I'm going to walk away thinking this was that UNLV team that went undefeated before they lost the national championship game to Duke,
Duke,
by the way. But I'm just telling you right now, we got a shot right now. If they're focused and they're ready and they want this, we got a shot at seeing a basketball team that can go undefeated for the entire year.
Undefeated and win the national title in the same season.
Are you as impressed as him?
I am. Now, let me say, Jalen Rose is right. These guys don't shoot.
Yeah.
And the key to them going undefeated is going to be moving that ball, because when you have every guy on the court can take their defender, then the kind of temptation is always, the short-term incentive is always, go get it. Go get those points. They're going to have to keep that ball in motion, the offense in motion. That'll be the key to them. I think they can do it. I think they are capable of going undefeated in the regular season. Very difficult, but I think they can do it. And I think they can win the national title. And I think this is good for college basketball. The difference between this and, let's say, Alabama or Golden State Warriors in the NBA, or what's another example of an incredibly dominant team?
UConn women's basketball?
Is that when you have the dominant name brand storied franchise or team that trots out year after year the championship team, and then one year they have this incredible juggernaut that cannot be stopped, that kind of ruins the sport because they win every year. It gets boring. The Patriots, again, it's boring. The Warriors, again, it's boring. Alabama, and this is the best version of them maybe ever, it's kind of boring. It's ruining college football this season. Not Duke. Duke is the storied franchise that's been in the mix but hasn't been just destroying everyone every year. And now, because of the nature of college basketball, a regular season, which many people ignore, is now interesting. Look at this Duke team. And then the tournament, because it's one and done, increases the odds they may get upset. This is great for college basketball. And the reason I think they can go undefeated, potentially, it's very, very early, and then win the whole thing, guys, why couldn't UNLV do it? Because Duke had Coach K.
Yeah.
Why couldn't the Fab Five win the whole thing?
Well, we know why. That was a different story.
Okay, fine. But still, Coach K got in the way of a lot of teams. And now he's playing in the one-and-done sandbox, right? He's like, okay, everyone else, you're playing. Now I'm playing one-and-done. But these one-and-dones are being coached by Coach K. They have a chance. It's ridiculously early. They have a chance to do what hasn't been done in a long time.
First of all, a couple of things. Number one, let's not act. Every time we talk about the Fab Five not winning the national championship, everybody points to the timeout that wasn't a timeout by Chris Webber. Let's remember that the year before that, they got annihilated by 30. By UNLV. I'm sorry, by Duke, all right? So let's remember that. That's number one. Number two, everybody's talking about shooting. I don't see a team that can't shoot. Zion can hit perimeter shots. Barrett can hit perimeter shots. Cam Reddish can shoot, okay? And there is something to be said. Remember, we're talking about kids. We're not talking about an NBA team. We're talking about kids. And if ever there are individuals that could be demoralized, it's on a basketball court. See, with football, you have so many different components. Mm-hmm. On a basketball court, if you got one superstar, that can intimidate a team. If you got two, it can overwhelm a nation in college basketball. Yeah. If you got three, it's like almost hopeless. And I'm just telling you right now, listen. The Kentucky Wildcats were supposed to have the number two recruiting class in the nation.
It was not a contest.
It wasn't a contest.
No. Yep.
And I'm like, and you look at Zion, he's 270.
But you know what it's like?
With a handle.
Who can pass and dribble. It's like an NFL team that has a great quarterback who can run. The temptation is always for the quarterback to pick up the first down with his legs because he can. But the short-term incentive can interfere with the long-term incentive because playing out of the pocket, you can get hurt. You may not have the same vertical kind of game.
Right.
This team is like that. They can crush everyone because every player on the floor can take their defender at any time. The temptation will be to hold the ball. And the reality is going to have to be to go undefeated. They got to keep it moving.